This episode in the 2019 Integrated Data Viewer tutorial series will explain how to show transects of your data. We'll start by opening Transect View. You can open it in a window by itself. I know that I'm going to be using the map view a lot, so I'll open them both in the same window. Now we have the two views that we want. The map view is over here. It's a slightly different shape, but it works exactly the same as when we only had the map view window open. This grid-looking pane on the other side is the transect view. Click on it to make it the active pane. A blue border should show up. At this point, the transect view is just a grid. It doesn't even get a location until we put in some data. I'm going to load in some model data so that we have something to work with. And why not work in Alaska today? Transects of vorticity can be pretty useful. Now, I'm not going to do any analysis, but it is very good for an example case. And we also really only need one time step for the demo. When you go to select a display type, make sure that you pick one of the ones under vertical cross sections. So if you look at the transect view, you can see it's still blank, but it does have a location. The current transect is always shown as a green line in the map view pane that begins at B and ends at E. The problem now is that the current transect isn't in Alaska, but our data is. So we have two options. We could move our transect or we could create a new one. In either case, we start by opening the transect drawing control. The mode icons here have descriptions, which you can see by hovering over them. I'm selecting the one that allows simple click and drag drawing. As before, the transect begins at B for beginning and ends at E for end. With the transect in the data domain, we can actually see the cross section of the data. To see a different cross section, just draw a new transect. You can switch back to previous transects by using the Transects tab at the top of the pane. If your cross section seems squished or if it isn't showing at all, try adjusting the vertical scale. Other display settings can be changed in the dashboard, like the color scheme. You might think that Transect View is just for three-dimensional data, but any two-dimensional field with a dimension of either height or pressure can also be plotted. As you can see, this type of cross section is less colorful, but it can still be very informative. Even though Transect View itself doesn't process data well without a vertical coordinate, you can still make a cross section. Set up the plot in the exact same way as you would if you expected it to show up in the transect view. Now, what we see here isn't much, just a colored line at zero. But if we go back to the dashboard, we can see that the data was actually plotted correctly, just in a different location. Notice that the z-axis is the variable that we selected and not a vertical coordinate. Now you should be able to use the transect view to see cross sections of your own data. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our website at unidata.ucar.edu or email us at support-idv@unidata.ucar.edu.